So we know that order of reaction, that is number of reactant molecules taking part in chemical reaction. So first order reaction, the reaction in which rate of reaction depends upon concentration of only one reactant, it's called first order reaction. Today we are going to study integrated rate law for first order reaction. First order reaction means the reaction in which rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration of only one reactant. So consider this reaction. Here reactant is A, which will produce a product. So differential rate law for this equation is rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration of A, as the product will form the concentration of reactant will consume. So here negative sign is taken. So rate of reaction is equal to minus d dt of concentration of A, which is equal to K into concentration of A. So here A is concentration of reactant at time t. So rearranging this equation, dA upon A is equal to minus K into dt. Same variable are taken on same side. So now A0 will be the initial concentration at time t equal to 0. Initial concentration of reactant A, which is A0, and after time t it will become AT. So AT is the concentration after time t. Now integrating this equation by taking limits of concentration A0 at AT, and limits of time are 0 to t, initial time 0 and final time t. So by integrating this equation we will get natural log of concentration of A. Here lower limit is A0 and upper limit is AT, equal to minus K into concentration of T. Lower limit is 0 and upper limit is T. So natural log of AT minus natural log of A0 equal to minus KT. We know that subtraction of log is denoted by this step. Ln AT upon A0 is equal to minus KT. So again rearranging, KT is equal to, so we have reversed this equation, so negative sign becomes positive. So KT is equal to ln of A0 upon AT. Here multiply by minus 1. So we will get K equal to, so dividing by T to this step. So K equal to 1 upon T ln A0 upon AT. Now natural log can be converted into, here base is taken as 10. So multiply by 2.303. So in this way natural log is converted into our simple log. And unit of this rate constant K is per second, because here time is in the denominator. So it is per second or per minute or per hour. In this way integrated rate law expression for first order reaction. Here rate of reaction is denoted by minus d dt of A equal to K into A. Rearranging this step, here A0 initial concentration AT, concentration of reactant after time t. So integrating this equation we will get this type. Get natural log of concentration of AT, here A0 equal to minus KT, and then that natural log is converted into simple log. Now half life of reaction. Half life means the time required, the half time required for हाफ रिएक्शन. सो सपोज वन कंप्लीट रिएक्शन इज देयर, देन टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर देयर एंड दैट रिएक्शन इज फुल टाइम. वी हैव टू अज्यूम ओनली हाफ ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट विल फॉर्म. सो टू फॉर्म हाफ प्रोडक्ट हाफ टाइम विल रिक्वायर. सो द हाफ लाइफ ऑफ रिएक्शन इज द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द रिएक्टेंट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू फॉर्म वन ऑफ द वन हाफ इट्स इनिशियल वैल्यू. द हाफ लाइफ ऑफ रिएक्शन इज द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द रिएक्टेंट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू फॉर्म टू वन हाफ ऑफ इट्स इनिशियल वैल्यू. एग्जैक्टली हाफ टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द रिएक्शन is half life period. So we know that equation for rate constant is k equal to 2.303 upon t into log to the base 10 a 0 upon at. This is equation for rate constant for first order reaction. Now here a 0 initial concentration, at concentration after time t. Now here time required for A0 to become A0 by 2 is T half. Means concentration time required for concentration become half is T half. So AT is equal to A0 upon 2 and T is equal to T half. So put this two values in place of AT, put A0 upon 2 and in place of T put T half. So rate constant is 2.303 upon T half into log to the base 10 A0 upon 2. So here A0 will get cancelled and that 2 will goes in numerator. So 2.303 upon T half into log to the base log 10 of 2. Log 2 is 0.3010. So multiply by 2.303. So it will 0.693 upon T half. Or T half is equal to 0.693 upon K. In this way, we can determine expression for half life period for first order reaction. These both expressions are very important from our examination point of view. Thank you.